Wait, I think this might be someone from a previous stream that's actually, like, kind of really good with Villager. Is that what it's supposed to look like? This is the villager from my Pyramithra stream. Oh. Oh, that could have been an axe. That was probably supposed to be an axe. We pressed down A instead of down B, probably. He would not feed me. That sometimes explodes in Ganondorf's face, and sometimes it actually, like, does something. Yeah, that's the thing that I was expecting to do when he hits the first Warlock kick. And I don't know what causes it to do one versus the other. Oof. Spacing. Did you see that micro spacing? I think that the main thing here is that I hold forward and they pivot backwards. Tech? Oh, if that had been a tech into, like, tech jump back air, he's gonna catch you with the jump. Oh, the nair! He finished it with the nair! Microspacing is just like the fact that that's all it is. Destroyed my tree with his tree. Chop down someone else's tree. Mm-hmm. never used that before. I use all the moves that no other character uses. Like villager down tilt. Oops, I was trying to catch that. I'm not gonna say G after every game, by the way. Every G is G. And I don't want to spend an hour just saying that over and over again. But yeah, that was a good game. I would have tried jabbing there, but it looked like it was actually not safe enough. This actually does not look like it's favored for a villager, just because they're both kind of, like, camping with projectiles, but sometimes me, Sword Fighter, is the projectile, and, like, projectiles get destroyed by non-projectiles, like swords especially. So sometimes it just feels like if they're staying at max distance from each other, then me, Sword Fighter, is winning. So then it's like, well, okay, well, what to do instead? Maybe, like, mid-range, but then he can, like, down-beat at any point in time. So then the only option is, like, close quarters. So if you actually hit with both the axe and also the tree, then it does shield break. Ooh. Ooh. Like, he caught the two frame and then hit the back air afterwards, and it killed even me, Sword Fighter. That bowling ball was to catch a air dodge in, by the way. That's the most common me, Sword Fighter. I just done for another nair, but this is so much, that's so much better. Probably down throw doesn't combo anymore. Jump backs, no? Okay. Ooh, it's not gonna kill. Nice nair though. That was a ledgery grab, so probably could have just gotten out rather than trying to do a drop down there, especially since it wasn't gonna kill. Probably could have gotten like a forward smash maybe. Why does the Lloyd Rocket look dead? It's because it's fashioned after the statues in Japanese culture that represent the dead. So that's why it looks dead. There's actually like a character in Animal Crossing that's just literally dead. But like no one ever realizes it unless they know all the lore behind the Lloyd Rockets. Or I guess not the Lloyd Rockets, but the Lloyds in that game. My wife was playing Animal Crossing New Horizons once, and like, I think their name is like Coco or something like that, I don't even know. But I was just like, I just happened to see her and I was, and I like asked my wife, like, why is there a zombie on your island? And they're like, what are you talking about? And I was like, no, there's like an actual undead walking around your village. You should probably evict her. The explosion that never hits. Large hollow earthen funeral objects in Japan. I don't have my time to read the rest of it. I like the tree counter play. It's a nice nair to jab.